have around 140,000 camel. And these are distributed mainly across the three counties, sub-counties. We have three sub-counties in Isiolo County. We have Marti, we have Galbatula, and we also have Isiolo Central. Our major threat in camel bond action is trypanosomiasis, which is brought by biting flies. Among them, we have the tsetse flies. Tsetse flies are concentrated around Kenya area. But in these other areas, we have the biting flies. And these ones increase in number when it rains or when we have a lot of patches. So we need to control the biting flies so that we can handle the zura in the camels. And it is a hope that in our continued collaboration with the CARI, we shall be able to build our staff on the control and management of zura itself, and then the pests, which are the biting flies, so that we can contain the situation. And once our staff are capable, then we shall go out there to the communities, because these animals belong to the communities and they are with the communities. So a lasting solution is to train or capable the staff, the community, so that they can handle their own animals. So we hope that collaboration will continue, and it is our hope that after that capacity building, the situation will be under control, and we shall be able to improve camel production in the county.
The objective of this research is to improve the livelihoods of pastoralists, specifically the camel keepers. We know that one of the greatest challenges to camel keeping is a disease called trypanosomiasis. This disease affects camel, it reduces the amount of milk that camels produce, it causes death, and by doing so, it affects livelihood. It means with the trypanosomiasis, there is less milk, it means there is less money in the pockets of farmers. So this project is here to address that problem of camel trypanosomiasis. And what we do, because it is a research project, we are collecting data. And with this data, we want to develop disease control strategies so that this disease that brings down the camel keeper is effectively controlled. If we find there's any sick animal, what we do that immediate treatment. We are collecting not only data from the animals, but we are also, because this disease is transmitted by biting flies that suck blood. In addition to animal sampling, what we do, we also go into the bushes to see what kind of flies are causing this disease. And once we get that data, we are also coming up with a way or a strategy to ensure that we bring those flies down. So the exercise here is we are collecting blood samples, and as we do, we are going to do screening on site. And once we find animals that are sick, we are going to treat. And as we treat, we are also advising farmers on the best thing to do. When the animals fall sick, then what should they do? That is also something that we are doing. We are encouraging them to seek services of the veterinary department. Actually, in this project, we are working very closely with the county veterinary staff so that when we exit at the end of this project, then they'll be able to take over to offer that advice and the services that the farmers need. So what we are seeing is very high prevalences of this disease, up to 40% in some areas. Yeah, but on average, we are seeing prevalences of about 10%. But this, of course, varies with the site. It also varies with the season. We're advising farmers, once you control the disease, then you'll have more milk. So the other thing that we are also encouraging farmers and advising them is how to dispose of these products. Kenya, we are working in the counties of Marsabit and Isiolo. We are looking at the camel keeping ecosystem in the Horn of Africa that straddles from Somalia all the way to Kenya, northeastern Kenya. So, but in Kenya, these are the two sites where we are currently working. We have been funded by the African Union and up to about 100 million Kenya shillings. Camel zura is a chronic disease. Loss of body weight, there is tiredness, there is loss of appetite, and all those other symptoms. So what farmers see, usually the first sign that a farmer see would be an animal that gets tired, and an animal that is producing less milk, an animal that is not feeding very well. So those are the first signs of that the animal will see. And what we're encouraging them to do is when immediately they see this sign, then they should reach out to the county veterinary office or any other qualified veterinary personnel so that they can do the diagnosis and then the animal is treated at the right time.